Hello and welcome to the Illustrator tutorial. Today we're going to learn how to make your own graphics with the program Illustrator. As an example, we're going to list all the components that you need for polymerase chain reaction. What is this fancy stuff? Well, it's some science stuff to get those pictures like this one that you see in CSI and Authors crime series. However, you don't need to care about the science stuff. I'm just going to use this as an example to show you a lot of techniques that you can apply for every graphic that you want to create with Illustrator. We're going to start by creating a reaction tube today, and in the next video we're going to create all the other stuff you see here. So let's get started with our reaction tube. We start by creating a new file, and the setting print should normally be fine. However, if you want to choose another setting, make sure that this checkbox here is always deactivated, because if you activate this, it will apply a grid to your document and your objects in your workspace will snap to this grid. So this prevents you from aligning objects accurate to each other. So we always want to have this unchecked. We can go on OK. And the first thing we want to draw is a reaction tube. I have a template on a website for this tube. It's just a picture. And we can save this on the desktop and then bring it into Illustrator. You might want to rescale it a little bit and make sure to press the shift key while doing so. And then we're going to zoom in and I'm going to show you layers. You find your layers panel in here, and each object on your pasteboard is assigned to a layer. You see this by the blue color. If you select an object, the color is blue as well as in layer 1. If you want to create a new layer, you can click this button and you can move objects around to different layers by just moving this rectangle. So this is now in layer 2. We want to put it back to layer 1 because now we want to lock this one. We can't select this because it's in layer 1 and layer 1 is locked, and you might also want sometimes to toggle visibility. And if we go now to layer 2, reselecting layer 2 as our active layer, we can now draw on top of this tube without being afraid to move it out of position. We start drawing by using the pen tool and we start clicking over here. And then we press the shift key to get a straight line. And we have a rounding down here. So we're going to click in the middle and hold and drag. And by pressing the shift key, we can make sure to get this rounding straight. We could now try to go around this edge and imitate the form of the tube, but it wouldn't be the same as on this side. So the way to do this is to reflect this object. You can go on right click, transform, and then on reflect. And if you go on copy, it will reflect your tube. If you press command U, you activate smart guides that will help you to align both sides well to each other. We can zoom in on the middle, and you see with the direct selection tool, you have actually 2 points here. You want to merge the 2 lines, and we can do this by selecting both points and then connect selected endpoints. Like this. Now it's connected and we have 1 point. Let's zoom out a little bit. Next, we want to create the top of the tube that is a little bit extended. To do this, we're going to use the ellipse tool. If you don't see this one right here, you can click and hold to open this drop-down menu. With the ellipse tool, we're going to draw the top of the tube, and we need to copy this one a few times, and you want to move it to the side. We save this one for later, and then we align them like this, and we take the rectangle tool to draw the spacing between them, like this. If you would now fill this one with a color, make it white, you see where we want to go. We would now place this one on top, but before we do that, we're going to use the pathfinder tool and we're going to merge this whole shape to one big block, like this. We can copy the top one again and place it on top. And now I would like to get this object down here as a single object that does not overlap the top one. So I'm going to select both and press this button, the divine button, and this will group both objects immediately. So we can ungroup this, take a look what did happen. It did cut down the lower part and separated the upper part. I think having it grouped is a good idea, so I'm going to undo this. And now we have our lid. You can place it on top. And maybe we need to scale it down a little bit, like this. And we use the align tool over here to center both objects. This should be fine. And now we take care of the lid. So we're going to copy the whole object here. And the lid is drawn out on the right side a little bit in this direction. So we go with our direct selection tool and we just move this one to the side. This is maybe a little bit much. Let's take less, like this. As this already looks a little bit like a reaction tube, it's also a good time to save our document. Let's call it PCR. And then we can continue. Down here, we see still it has a little bit overlap in here. We can copy the whole thing and paste it. And then we want to use our Pathfinder tool and click the divide button. And this will make single objects out of everything. We can ungroup this. We can group this one and then take this part and move it down to our tube. You see it's not aligned perfectly, so we're going to select the whole thing and use our align tool and press this button to get the alignment right. In our layers panel, we select this part and we see it's this one here, and we're going to toggle the visibility. We ungroup this object and then delete the old part of the tube. If we now turn the visibility on again, we see we have single objects and they are perfectly aligned to each other. We can get rid of this one. And then I would like to add a little knob down here to close our tube. However, I want to do a backup of this one first in case I mess up something. Just put it to the side. And now we start with our knob. To create our knob, we need to ungroup this one and we copy this here, put it to the side. Then we want to deactivate our smart guides by pressing Command U, and now we can scale this how we want. Let's see if the size is all right. Yeah, this should close our tube. And I want also to increase the thickness, so the height of this one. And with the direct selection tool, I'm going to move this up a little bit. If I want to align this one now to my tube, I press Command U again, but now the center of this one has changed. If you put it in here, it's not really in the center because we have this little knob right here. So we need to copy this one and place it on our tube. Actually, let's select our backup and put it into another layer because it's a little bit annoying with the smart guides feature. Just move it down to this layer. We're going to lock and hide it so it doesn't affect our smart guides. Let's move this one out of the way as well. Now we can place our knob onto our tube. This should be fine. We can get rid of this one and let's move it down a little bit, like this. We now see we still have some overlap in here, so we copy the whole thing and we're going to use again the trick with a pathfinder to create our special object in here. Make sure to ungroup this one and then we place our object on top of this one. This doesn't look right, as this line is a little bit too thick. I don't think they are aligned very well. And if we go on outline, we see they're a little bit off. So to fix this, we're going to move this one up, select both of them, and align them on the bubble. If we now go on outline, this looks much better. Can go on preview again, hide this one, and delete the old one, and then show this one again. Finally, we group this one, and there we have our perfect lid. We can take back our tube and can get rid of this one. And now we want to reflect our lid. We can rotate it a little bit. And we're finally going to connect those both things with our pen tool to make a plasticky connection. Let's use a pen tool to draw a connection between both lids. This should be the first one. And then the second one on top. Like this. We can move them out of the way. And then we're just going to connect both endpoints with the direct selection tool. We can move this back on position. And then we're going to arrange it to the back. We can now take a look at our tube. And this doesn't look that bad. However, I also want to have a closed tube that has a closed lid. So we're going to go to our backup and we're just going to align our lid with the rest of the tube. Let's take our old tube and move it out of the way. We can hide this layer and move our new tube on our template. We need to send this to the back. And this doesn't look as it is correctly aligned. Let's try this again. And check again in the outline view. This should be fine now. And as always, we want to copy this one and use the pathfinder to get this object right, because we have now overlap here and we don't want this. Select the whole thing, go to your pathfinder, and then we're going to ungroup this one again. Here's the part we want. We can get rid of the rest. And in here, we want to hide the top for a second. And we need to ungroup this one. We don't need this part. And we're going to place this one on top. This should be fine. We can delete the one in the background and bring back our top lid. Let's group the whole thing, and now we only need to add the little plastic thing that connects the lid and our tube. As always, you want to use a pen tool for this. This should be fine. We can copy this one and rescale it. Yeah, maybe something like this. And we want to connect our endpoints again. Now we can bring it back to our tube. And we're going to send it to the back. Maybe we can squeeze it a little bit. Like this. Alright, I'm happy with this one. Let's group this as well. And let's take a look at our final results. We can make this layer visible again And oh, this is not grouped. We group this as well. And there we have our two tubes. Let's save this document, and I would say we continue in the next part of this tutorial. Okay, there we have our basic reaction tube. Now we need to fill it with a lot of stuff, and you see the things over here that we want to draw in the next tutorial. You can click on the picture to watch the tutorial. So, see you in the next video. Bye bye!